Now, I request Srivatsa, the Vice Chairman of Sikasa Bengaluru, to escort the session chairman, Dr. Sarvamanagla Khanapuri, onto the dais and give a flower bouquet.
She is going to instill in you a faith so strong that every time you go into the world, you will emerge as the winner. Are you all ready to be the winner? Can we hear it one more time? Are you all ready to be the winner? Put your hands together for the founder and CEO of Bliss Mind Apps, Dr. Sarvamanagla Khanapuri. She will enlighten us on the theme, Win Yourself to Win the World. I request the Vice Chairman of Sikasa to introduce to us Dr. Sarvamanagla Khanapuri.
Giriya Melake, Dodda Bandayanu Sisipasanu, Urulisira Londaradu Maru Ghasiyali, Saridu Kelakada Dento Jaru Vudu Maramarali, ಪುರುಷ ಪ್ರಗತಿಯಂತೂ ಮಂಕುತಿಮ್ಮ ಅಭ್ಯುದಯ ಸನದಿಲೆಕ್ಕಿಗ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿ ಸಮಾವೇಶದ ಎರಡನೆಯ ದಿನಕ್ಕೆ ಮತ್ತೊಮ್ಮೆ ಸ್ವಾಗತ. ಯಶಸ್ಸು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಗೆಲ್ಲ ಬೇಕೇ ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಕೋತೀವಲ್ವಾ? ನಮ್ಮ ದಾರಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಯಶಸ್ಸಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನೋ ಒಂಥರ ಕಳ್ಕೊಂಡಂಗೆ. ಆ ಯಶಸ್ಸು ಇನ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಅಭ್ಯುದಯ ಸನದಿಲೇಖಿಗ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿ ಸಮಾವೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ರಿಗೂ ಸಿಕ್ಕೇ ಸಿಕ್ಕತ್ತೆ. ಹಾಗೆ ಅಭ್ಯುದಯ ಸಮಾವೇಶ ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಒಂದು ರೀತಿಯ ಅಡಿಪಾಯ. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಮೈ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ವೆಲ್ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಟು ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎರುಡೈಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನಾಲಿಟಿ, ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಸರ್ವಮಂಗಳ ಖಾನಾಪುರಿ, founder and CEO of Bliss Mind Apps. She is a CSIR Research Fellow awardee for the year 2011. She has presented her research papers in various forums at the international level. Madam Sarvamanagla is basically a spiritual scientist, counselor, soft skill trainer, hypnotherapist and yoga therapy consultant. She has excelled in the field of counseling, cosmic healing, meditation, and many more. Around 20,000 students and 3,000 adults have received free training on meditation and power of subconscious mind. She is a faculty at ICAI Bengaluru chapter for personality development workshops, and more than 3,500 chartered accountants have been trained by her in the field of personality development. She is a recipient of Sri Guru Seva Ratna Award 2017-18, Akka Award, Karnataka Gnana Ratna, Rashtriya Vignana Ratna, and many more. She is also the writer of Kannada Monthly Magazine, Kanakambara. Win yourself to win the world. Without further ado, with melodious round of applause, let us welcome our session chair, Dr. Sarvamanagla Khanapuri. Over to you, ma'am.
Happy morning to all of you. Happy morning. Not hearing. Okay, good. At this onset, my heartfelt gratitude. The first I would like to give my gratitude to the Vice Chairman, C.A. Ravindra Koreji, for gifting me this opportunity to come and deliver this talk in front of you today. And also C.A. Lata and C.A. Divya, who coordinated along with this. And also to all the organizing members of this particular event, which is indeed a great success. And also to all the delegates, the student delegates, my humble, heartfelt gratitude to all of you. I'm just telling the beginning only. Okay, so thank you for being here to listen to me for next probably for 45 minutes, because we are running little bit. There's a little bit of time management to be done over here, which we do in our classes. So the same thing has to continue over here. So next 45 minutes, I can deliver my best if you are there over here 100%. So shall I take it that you are there 100% over here? So let us have a test. All these classes, I just wanted to ask you, who are the students who have attended my classes, like GMCS and orientation? Can you just raise your hands? Okay, yeah, I'm seeing there also. Probably it's almost 75% students, okay, who have attended my class. So let me just take it in a different way today, whatever I delivered in the class. And then if you are a little bit in a listening mode, I can give my best, so that if we have little bit time remaining, probably 10 minutes, 15 minutes, then for others who have not got the essence of unleashing the potential, I can give a practical demo to them also, because there are some 20 or 30% students who have not attended my classes. Okay, so is it okay for others? Okay, so thank you. So now, win yourself to win the world. The first set is, if I have to go outside and win the world or conquer the world, it doesn't mean that I have to go with all the tools and things and then win and do something very harsh. So the first and foremost is how I can win within myself. So what is it, those things which are very much required, wherein I need to either sacrifice or let go or give away or permanently press Control Alt Delete, so that some things are not there within me, so that I can explore something better within me. So winning yourself, can you just tell me what it actually means? What we're supposed to win within ourselves? Can you give me a few examples? The negative thoughts, and then procrastination, and then pardon? Fear, okay. And then the balcony? Balcony, students are more in comfort zone. Huh? Because we can concentrate more down rather than looking up. But I'm looking at you also, okay? My concentration is more towards the balcony. Got it? So now we'll do a small exercise. I want all of you to participate in this. So leave all your books and everything aside and take your left hand like this, and then draw a triangle. All of you just participate, draw a triangle, so it's possible. So now take your right hand and draw a circle, okay? So it's possible. So now I request you to take your left hand and then again your right hand, both together, okay? Both together, left hand draw the triangle, right hand draw the circle, together. So together you're going to do it, left hand and then right hand. So operate together. So let me see, will you be able to do it? You're able to do it? Okay. Very few of you will be able to do it. So most of us fail to do. There's a problem. There's a conflict management to be done between your left brain and right brain. So today, if we have to win on our own self, it means that I have to take a charge so that I create a kind of a balance between my left and right brain and then also my body. So if you have to become an excellent consultant, an excellent professional CA, or to run your business for the future, so the most basic instrument is, the tool is your body. If you are unwell, if you are not physically fit, sound both mentally and physically, we will not be able to give our best. So from last 10 years, probably in my high school days, I started with physical fitness in a very smaller way. But today, I've seen the benefit of that. I'm much, much better than my age group people who belong to my age. So can you just guess my age? Okay. So now, when compared to others of my age group, I feel more energetic and more self-driven. Why means, this is because the both physical and the mind should be coordinated. So let us see one by one how to unfold ourselves for the betterment and leave few things which are not required, like throwing away the baggage. So winning, if I have to reach my goal is somewhere there, I have set it, probably 1 year, 3 years, 5 years or 10 years ahead of today. If I have to walk the path till there, I have to be physically and mentally fit and sound. So if I have to walk that path and reach it, so what best I can do for today at this present moment? So let us see what best we can do. So winning isn't getting ahead of others, it is getting ahead of yourself. So today we will see how to get ahead of our own self. You can see here some of the images, and daily basis on your messages, you will be texting these smileys or these emojis. So most of them, what you're seeing over here, it is all a kind of a negative feelings rather than positive. So as you named before, there are many different kind of a feelings or emotions. So I have just listed few. It may be anger, annoyance, impatience, the fear of competition, fear of rejection, or you may have hopelessness, helplessness, jealousy, frustration, and also a stress which has been built within yourself. So lack of confidence, low self-esteem. So the previous speaker, when the time was mentioned, like they came and gave a small chit that your time is up. Did you see at the final? He was very calm and quiet. At the end, when the chit was given, suddenly little bit stress came into the picture. Why means we have to wind up within next 1 or 2 minutes. So this small stress also will create a misalignment between your speech and then your brain cells. The thoughts which are supposed to be expressed outside, they don't come in the very calm and composed manner. So you lose your patience, or a kind of a fear, will I be able to complete or finish it off? So we'll see now what best we can do to achieve this in our life. So if I have to conquer my own kind of inhibitions, my own walls which I have created, my own blockages which are there within me, the first process which can be done is self-introspection. So at the beginning, they had asked you to close your eyes just for 1 minute, but still you are not able to do it. So we are so much distracted towards each and every thing which is happening surrounding to us, we are not letting ourselves to go within, deeper and deeper. So today, at the end of probably now, next half an hour or 40 minutes, you will really be able to get the best from within yourself. So I hope you will cooperate with whatever I'm going to guide you, or whatever knowledge I'm going to share from my side to you. So now we'll see here the image which is given. Everything we hear is an opinion, not a fact. Everything we see is a perspective, not a truth. So if two people are there, you have to manage things. But there what happens, the perception comes in between, the judgmental thing comes in between, which I am not able to accept the other person as they are. So today, the first key takeaway is acceptance. So bring that acceptance when you meet a person, when you see a situation, something wrong is happening, something bad is happening, some misunderstandings are taking place. So what is it? That is what the first thing comes is your acceptance towards that particular person and the situation. So the first acceptance, the second comes adjust. The three A's in your life. So take it very seriously. The three A's in your life, accept as it is. The second one is to adjust. The third one, but probably I'll tell, don't go for that. Avoid. So the moment you accept the person as they are, no problem of avoiding them. Everything comes in its place. So what are the three A's in your life to be remembered? Accept and then? Adjust. Otherwise, avoid. If it is too much, if I'm not able to manage. So we'll see now, one by one, how best we can do it. So what is the reason for the stress? So basically what happens? We have a lot of things in our mind, which we want to do many things or deliver. But along with that, we have something, a small thing called as expectation. So I hold an expectation if I'm doing something to others. So when I have an expectation, there's a gap created because reality may not happen the same way as I have expected from the other. So this small gap creates a inbuilt stress within you. So probably, can anybody tell me whether stress is really required? Do you feel we need stress? We need stress. So what is that particular stress called as? It's good or bad? It's good. So what is it termed as? Eustress. Okay, it's good. So good. If you don't have a date for this conference, if it's not mentioned 20 and 21st, then you'll not be knowing when to come, when it's holding, from what time to what time it's going to conclude. So there should be a little bit of a stress in your mind that, yes, this conference is there, I'm supposed to go over there, I'll attend, and I'll get the best out of the whatever they are going to deliver in this conference. So you have a date for your exam, a date for the interview, everything is there. But from today onwards, how to make everything as a eustress, not something which is different from eustress, wherein you become too much of negative about the same process or about the same date or time which has been mentioned. So what is it that creates this kind of a difficulty in managing the stress that leads to your distress? So the same event, the same talk, the same subject you're going to write in your exam, the same day you're going to deliver in the interview, whatever it might be, the way you're going to take it is what holds within you. So let us make ourselves free from all the distress and create only eustress in our life. So we'll see how to make it. So now, since I told about body and mind and brain, let us be very clear, because without this, I cannot do anything in my life. So when you have stress, when you have fear, when you have all this negative kind of inhibitions, your own walls which you are holding, nobody has pushed you towards that. It is you who have taken all this kind of negativity. So what happens to the body mechanism? Can anybody tell me, when you get stressed up, or when you have anger, when you have guilt, when you have rejection, so what is it that happens within your body or to your brain? Chemicals. Any idea? Your brain chemicals. Yes, sir. You have? You cannot focus on your goal. Okay. So focusing on your goal, yes, goal is there much before that. So what happens when you have all this negativity overloaded inside, within you, there is something called as hormonal imbalance takes place, which happens in a very subtle manner, but day by day, it enters into your physical body. So your mood swings, your thought process, and the brain cells, the neurotransmitters, are both interconnected. So we'll see now how to make ourselves free from all these kind of an imbalances. If you set your hormonal cells or hormonal chemicals balanced, then yes, it is possible for you to rule the world. So I'm supposed to rule on my own thought processes. So we'll see one by one what is the consequence or the side effects which comes into picture. Emotionally, you can see outburst. You feel low. You feel sad. When you don't get, or when somebody is not focusing on you, somebody is not appreciating you, somebody is not ready to listen to you. So what happens? Emotional outburst. And cognitive, it is connected to your mind, to your... So here what happens? Your negative thoughts, or you losing focus, losing the concentration, this is connected to your mind. The next problem is physical. So most of us feel that gastritis, or muscular joint pain, or even your weight loss, the rise, sudden rise in the weight, or even hair loss, most of them complain, pimples. So all these things can happen because of our own thought processes. And then comes your relationship issue, and then your behavior. So your relationship with your friends, or with your parents, or with anybody outside, it depends on your own chemicals. So let us see the importance of these chemicals, how we can generate instantly within us. And it is possible to do it. So now I like all of you to have a glance at this slide because it's very, very important. Anger weakens your liver. So whoever feels that you have lot of angriness, or you feel lot of anger within, or impatience, so be very careful. Slowly you will start sensing there's a problem in your digestion, the liver functioning. Everything will get impaired. Grief. So when you cry a lot within, when you sob also within yourself, so that weakens your lungs. This whole lung space gets weakened. And then comes your worries. We worry for everything. If I have to go for a conference, I worry. If I have to go for a class, I'm going to worry. Or getting up early morning for the GMCS classes, you have to be there at 7 o'clock. So it's a big worry, a trouble. How will I reach over there? So worrying for everything will weaken your stomach. And then if you're going to take stress, that affects your heart and brain cells. It is all interrelated. So fear weakens your kidney. And many such cases I have seen wherein fear has taken a toll of the kidney at a very, very young age. So now let us see how to bring a balance between all these things and how to maintain it together. So we'll do a small exercise now to show that how your mind is going to work and how your body will start listening to you. So are you ready? So all of you just see over here. Don't join your four fingers. Just join everything together and only keep your both of the four fingers apart. Okay? So now, all of you do it. Just keep it like this in front of you because I don't have a mic over there. I have to stand and do it here only. So I can show it from here. Or if somebody can hold me, mic. So now, keep it aside, keep it apart. All of you do it. And now I want you to concentrate on both of your fingers. So don't concentrate anywhere else. Focus on both of your fingers and feel that both the fingers are becoming like magnet and they're getting attracted towards each other so close that they're slowly coming together. They're becoming magnet and they're getting attracted towards each other. And yes, they're joining together, they're stuck like a glue. Both your fingers are stuck like a glue. Even though you try to separate, you're unable to separate them. They are completely glued, completely stuck, totally stuck. Even though you try to separate, you're unable to separate, you're completely unable to separate. Even though you try to do it, it will not be possible. And then slowly, one, two, three, relax. And now it's going to separate. Did you observe? Did you observe, all of you? Okay. So now, what did you see over here? It's your own mind power. Okay? Nothing else over here. Your mind can create, can make magic in your life. So now, if these two fingers can listen to you, then why not the whole body? The whole body also can listen to you. So now we'll see what is it that we are supposed to conquer on our own self. Okay? So we'll see now, one by one, what are those happy chemicals which we need to completely take it to ourselves. So this slide, whatever will be coming now, keep it in your mind, retain this picture in your mind permanently. Anything handled with acceptance, that becomes positive emotion. Anything handled with non-acceptance, that becomes a negative emotion. So, if you are going to reject something in your life, reject somebody in your life, that will persist in your life lifelong. So the best thing is to accept the way it is. The last 10 to 15 minutes, I will do a practical session for you, wherein you will come to know on a daily basis how to practice this particular thing. So, shall I do it? At the last 10 to 15 minutes, I'll do it for you. I'll take you for a wonderful journey. Okay? So now, once you accept the situation, everything will fall in its place. So what happens when we accept and keep away ourselves from distress? The physiology of your whole body, your mind, your behavior, all three are going to sync together. So that's the beauty of these practices. So this slide, what you're seeing over here, there's something called as past, future, and present. I will gift you a wonderful tool today, every moment, to come to the present situation. As you know, the mind is always in the past, thinking about something in the past which has already happened, where you cannot do any correction for today. And sitting over here, you're worried about something which is going to happen probably after my talk or after this day, or probably after 1 month or 2 months or 1 year. So if you're doing both, will it help you? Will it help you? If you're thinking about the past and worrying about the future, will it help you? No way it's going to help you. So the best thing is, now don't do daydreaming sitting over here. I'm standing in right in front of you. Just listen, okay? Huh? So don't go for a daydream. Abhyudaya. Okay? The name is so beautiful. It's an amazing concept. Abhyudaya means what? Anybody can tell me? The conference title. It is your growth, happiness, your abundance with respect to happiness, success, wealth, and health. Okay? So Abhyudaya means you're going to go in the exponential phase. Rise phase, the growth phase in your life. Abhyudaya can happen only if you are in the present moment. If you are going to go in the past and future, it can never happen in your life. The same way, if you have to attract in your life the wealth, happiness, success, it can happen only in the present moment. So we'll see how to make it to happen. So these slides which you're going to see over here is something called as happy chemicals. So can anybody tell me the name it is displayed? If you knew it before, do you know the concept of these happy chemicals? There are endorphins, oxytocin, dopamines, serotonins, cortisols. All these belong to the group of hormones, and others are neurotransmitters. So what does endorphin do to your body and mind. What happens when this chemical is released? It brings about the relief from the stress. It works like a painkiller. It is called as rock star. Endorphins are called as rock stars. So how to create it? If I have a pain, I have a stress, if I'm telling I'm stressed, I have a pain, I'm suffering, so it is going to become what? Low and low. The chemicals will become imbalanced. So instead, even though pain is there, so I have accepted the pain and I'm just witnessing as it is, not getting attached, not rejecting the pain or suffering or the stress. And what I'm going to tell? I'm very happy, I'm very calm, I'm very peaceful. Okay, my body is filled with strength and stamina. So what happens instantly? There'll be a rush of endorphins in your brain cells. Is it so difficult to do this practice? So just you have to create the thoughts in your mind. And it works instantly. And I mean it. And I do it on a daily basis. We'll do it afterwards. Once I complete everything, then we will do it together. And then you see dopamine. The dopamine, the main thing what it does is, it's like a motivator. The motivation. If you have to release dopamines into your body, if the brain cell has to release that, you need a motivation. So the motivation can be your goal in your life with respect to family and then your professional life with respect to physical and mental well-being. So when you have like dopamine secretion to be done, you meet your friend today or you meet your client or a customer. Is it very difficult to tell, wow, you're looking good, your dress code is very nice, I love your smile. Is it very difficult for you to tell or appreciate that? Is it difficult? No. You can do it. So what happens? Dopamine gets secreted. It's very easy to secrete these chemicals. Then comes your oxytocin. You meet your friend. In Munnama MBBS, there was Jadu Ki Jappi. So that Jadu Ki Jappi, if you give, you get oxytocin released automatically. So when you meet a friend, when you just say hi, or you hug them, or you give a shoulder to them, and then make that kind of a touch, the touch feeling. So that brings the bonding between the two of you, and that releases your oxytocin. So this is called hug drug or hug hormone. And then comes your serotonins. The serotonin, when you feel very lonely, very sad, so this completely collapses, this particular hormone. So when you start developing and feeling, I love myself, I appreciate myself, I am great, I am lovable. So now what happens? Serotonin gets easily, completely generated. So these four happy chemicals, from today onwards, it can be self-generated. And we will see how to make it to happen. So we will do a small practical demo so that you will realize and understand it better. Just go through this slide, because after that I should take you to a journey which involves these things. So all of you get some idea on a daily basis. And if that idea is really powerful from the divine source, we tell, it's like very positive and good. If you add feelings to that, you have got some idea, you're supposed to add feelings to that if you have to manifest it. So when you add your idea with the feelings, it will create the embryo of the manifestation. So then what happens? Step by step, you can just nourish it and cherish it, your own embryo, to develop and to manifest as your goal, as your dream. Because the last 10 minutes, I'll be addressing with this the same thing. So now keep your mind very clear with the idea and then the feeling. So what is it that you're supposed to add to your idea? Or you've got some dream in your mind. So if you have to create that, if you have to manifest it, then feeling has to be added. So why feeling has to be added, I will just explain you in a moment. So now, this process I'll do after some time. Now, if you add feeling to that, the manifestations will happen very fast. If you just tell, I'm happy, I'm healthy, I love myself, it will not work. Why means? Your subconscious mind does not understand that language at all. So what it's supposed to tell, I'm happy, I'm healthy, I love myself, I am great, okay, I am successful, I am a creator. So now what happens? All your dopamines, your endorphins, oxytocins, serotonins, everything come to the balanced state. So is it very difficult for you to do that? It's very simple. Okay. So now we'll do it together and then I'll go for the other session. So now all of you, wherever you are, I want you to just spring up. I'll show you how to do spring up. Okay. So when I tell spring up, you're supposed to spring up. So you're sitting. You're in the most comfortable position now. Okay. So all of you are sitting. So when I tell you spring up, you should do like this. So now, I know all of you are sitting. How much time? 20 minutes. No, we'll see. Okay. See now, wherever you're sitting, be prepared now. Leave all your cell phone, your book, that, this and all aside. Spring up! Good. Sit. Spring up. Good. Awesome. Sit down. Thank you. Spring up. Lovely. Okay, be there. Be there. Don't sit. Okay. So now, let us do this exercise together. Let us do it together. Okay. And put your feelings. Put everything together while doing this process. I am happy. I am healthy. I love myself. I respect myself. I am an achiever. I am great. I am successful. I am a creator. I love myself. I respect myself. I am a creator. I am great. I am a champion. I am a champion. I am a champion. Yes. 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 Thank you. You can sit down. So now, is it so difficult to create these hormones within yourself? It's possible. So from today onwards, what you're supposed to kill, what you're supposed to sacrifice, control, alt, delete. So all the negativities, I have to finish in next 10 to 15 minutes. So if you are silent, then I can finish it off. Okay? So can you just maintain silence? I'll give you two or three very beautiful techniques. If you practice it for next 21 days, you'll be away from all the unwanted baggages. Okay? So will you do it? For next 21 days, the first practice is take a piece of paper, write all the negative emotions which are bothering you. It may be any of that from the list. So write that negative emotion, 1, 2, 3, 5, 10, how much ever it is, and then burn it off. You're supposed to burn that chit. So now from your thoughts, it went to your paper. So the emotions have flown from your mind to the paper. That's a beauty. So you're going to just witness you are not that person. And when you burn, it will convert it into ash. So slowly you can see you're free from that particular unwanted trait which we have developed as self. The second beautiful process is just write down and witness, introspect. Should I react from next time or should I respond to the situation? If you respond, you're going to change your destination. You're going to change your destiny. If you're going to react, then you'll fail utterly in creating your well-being. So daily introspect, write it, and how better I can do it. Because you're witnessing. You're not that person. You're just witnessing. And that time, the shift will happen in your mind. If your anger is right now here, your mind will cannot think better when you're in this position. When you're keeping it apart and when you're shifting your position, then only your mind is going to come to that. It's going to change. So you cannot get solution from the same mindset from where the problem has arisen. So you have to always hold it apart, aside from you. The third process which you can do on a daily basis. So in your mind and in your body, take 2 or 3 unwanted emotions and just tell that the fear in me is dead. Okay, the lazy person in me is dead. So just do this affirmations and see the beauty of your path, of your journey. And one very simple technique is take a balloon, blow the balloon. In that balloon, you're supposed to put the negative emotions. So while blowing, blow the fear, blow the worry, blow the laziness, blow the negative thoughts, and then burst the balloon. You will see a sudden shift in your state of mind. Okay? So now I told you in the beginning, smile is the very precious jewel. So now we will do all of us together for next 5 minutes so that this process, you can follow it every day in your home or whichever place you are there. So let us do together this particular process. So now, let all of us become a smile millionaire. So when you become a smile millionaire, you can mint money, that is sure. Not only money, you can also attract success into your life. It is possible. So we all of us do this very simple exercise, and to do this, 1 minute only it was difficult for you to stop from the external distractions. Now my humble request is for 5 minutes. Okay, for 5 minutes, I'm asking with a smile. So for 5 minutes, just you, I will take you to an inward journey wherein we will experience the smile relaxation, and along with that, I will make your mind fertile enough to sow the seeds for your goals and for your future. Okay, so do you agree? Is it okay? I cannot see the balcony, okay, but I trust that, I trust you will do it. Okay, because you are my student, so I trust you. Okay, so now, 3 C's in your life. What are 3 A's? Do you remember? What? Accept, adjust, avoid. So now 3 C's in your life will be conviction, commitment, consistency. Okay, the 3 C's in your life. So do this process with conviction. Okay, so now I request all of you, it's a very beautiful process, and do it in your place when you go back, at least once in a day. I'll just show you once, initially how to begin, and then I'll be guiding you. Okay, so now the first thing is,
when you take your breath, and then when you're releasing out, not from your nose, not from your nostril, it has to come out from your mouth. Okay? I'll let you know how to do it. Okay? You're going to open your mouth wide enough. And while opening your mouth, you're releasing out all your stress, all your concerns, all your worries, all your fear, all your anxiety. Got it? So do it 100%, you will get immediate result now only. So now I request all of you to sit straight. Don't lean back. Do this. Do this with commitment, conviction and commitment. So to cut down from all the external diversions and distractions, I request you to close your eyes and do this. Okay, all of you, because I cannot come and see you individually. You will get best result only when you do it. So now, I request you to close your eyes, and my humble request to close your mouth also. Okay? Only you have to exhale. No voice to be, only ha should come. There is no other talk. Okay? That's all. Done? Ready? Okay. So now, just gently close your eyes. So now, take a deep breath from your navel portion. Inhale deeply. Ha. Just release out. Don't make noise. Don't make sound. Just air should come out. Okay, now do it properly. Do it continuously for 10 to 11 rounds. You're just taking deep breath. See, you're being monitored because video is being shooted. So do it properly, at least for video sake. Okay, so inhale. So open your mouth, otherwise it will not give you any result. Open your mouth and do it. Release all your fear, all your stress, all your worries through your breath. So just continue doing it for 3 to 4 rounds, and through your mouth feel that you're releasing all your stress, all your worries, all your concerns, all your fear. And now relax, and now relax yourself. Keep your eyes closed, relax yourself and bring a smile on your face. Bring a gentle smile on your face. Smile. Smile. Now take your smile to your entire face. Feel that your whole face is smiling. Smile. Smile. No talking, just do it. Now take your smile to your shoulders, to your spinal cord, to your chest portion, and feel all these parts are smiling. Now slowly take your beautiful smile to your stomach, hip joints, buttock, your whole legs, your thighs, your knee joint, and feel your entire body is now smiling. Smile, smile. Just do it and see the magic. Just do it, okay? And now, all of you, very seriously, I'm requesting you for the next 1 minute or 2 minutes, give your 100%. Give your 100%. Now, with the closed eyes, just observe your mind. Observe your thoughts. The thoughts would have reduced. You may get one or two thoughts or some images of your near and dear ones. Whatever thoughts are coming, whatever images you're getting, just observe them.
Don't attach nor reject. Just witness those thoughts. You're just witnessing. No attachment, no rejection. And witness it with a smile. Witness with a smile. And as you smile, the thoughts are going to dissolve and the images are going to become blur. So your mind is now becoming a beautiful white canvas wherein you can create your future and rewrite your destiny. So today you're going to become the director, actor, producer, scriptwriter for your own future. So my dear students, do this process in your mind and see the beauty of manifestation of your idea and your feelings. So add your feelings to that. On your mind's beautiful white canvas, I request you to paint the pictures of your future with respect to your personal life and your professional life. And see all those images coming alive. Visualize that everything has happened and yes, you have achieved it. So create those beautiful pictures. You're now going to put the seeds in the form of affirmations, in the form of visualization. You're putting the seeds in the fertile land of your mind. So create your own future. If you have to qualify, yes, the year of qualification. When you want to get your CA as a CA and then your name and put a year over there and you're going for an interview to get 100% over there that you are through that interview, do it in your mind first. And also your next 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, all that which you want in your life, first create and manifest in your mind. Everything happens twice in your life, once in your mind, in your dream, once in reality. So give your 100% right now to this process. And feel everything coming alive and the manifestation happening. So bring all these feelings alive and yes, you have proved it and you have made it. You have created your path and feel your journey and feel your self-worth. Feel the value system towards yourself and everything coming alive. So slowly when you feel and sense your dream has come true, you have achieved. Yes, you are the creator. You have empowered yourself today. You have killed in all the inhibitions which will not allow you to go for the future unfolding of your own potentials. So you are the creator of your own life and you're writing your own self-creation. So now, once you've done this in your mind, take it as a blueprint in your mind and transfer that copy into every cell of your body. So transfer that copy into every cell of your body and feel that it has happened and live in the moment. When you feel it has happened, slowly, gently, you may now open your eyes. If you have really given 100% commitment to whatever was told right now, you are going to achieve it 100%. It is guaranteed. Because this is the most wonderful process which you can do on a daily basis. I would like to end with a beautiful video. I would like to invoke the lion in you. So we will just see this beautiful video so that it will help you to just create your own path, which we had never ever even felt that these things can happen.
King of the jungle that rules over all the animals. But that is not true. Every lion doesn't become a king. Here is the story. A lioness gives birth to up to 7 cubs. Intruder lions or a new lion in the group kill most of the cubs. And some cubs die because of disease or get eaten by other beasts. Most of the cubs die before the age of 2. The cubs who survive and become adults are kicked out by the most senior male. The young lions are now all alone and are attacked by other big lions and get killed. Only powerful, intelligent, and healthy lions survive till the end. Very few of them get into a new lion family and become a part of it. And later, they become the leader. The real struggle starts here. Intruder lions keep attacking him. A lion dies early than a lioness because he has to fight every day to protect the group. His whole body has visible wound marks made by teeth and claws of other lions while protecting the group. He has to prove every day that he is the king by fighting for his kingdom. He lives for pride and dies for the pride. So if you want to live life of a lion, you must understand that life is very hard and you must fight to survive. The whole world is ready to attack you, drag you down and criticize you. But you must keep moving ahead with a big, fearless heart like the lion. And one day, the whole world will accept you as a leader, as a majestic personality. Become a king, become a fighter, be unstoppable, and be a lion.
Okay, with this video, I just came across this video just 2 days back, to be very frank to you. I was just searching in my mind what best I can give for this day to just conclude this particular session or talk, and look at the law of attraction, the law of manifestation. And I just clicked one particular video on the WhatsApp, and this particular video came, and it really created a new insight within me also. And I felt, yes, this video has to be shown over here. So this is where your ideas and then the feelings together, the commitment for this class, the best should be given for today. So that came like a package, like this small video. So just I request all of you to go out by today evening after all the seminars are done, to be the lion, to take that courage, to just give the sacrifices and to survive at the very toughest and very hardest, because we are prone to many things in our life. So criticism, yes, let us welcome it and let us take it as a feedback, and then we are supposed to move on. So I trust I have done justice for today's session. I trust, okay. So I would once again, my heartfelt gratitude to the organizers of this wonderful session, and also to all the student delegates. And probably this inspiring video, let it keep inspiring and motivating you lifelong to be the lion. And you can follow many practices. You can watch videos, even my own videos are there. You can watch them on YouTube. And anything further, you can always check it. You can get the best out of it. So now, the three A's. Three A's. Accept, adjust, avoid. Avoid should be last. The three C's, conviction, commitment, consistency. the last, the four D's. I will wind up the session with the four D's. The four D's, the first one is discipline. The second one comes determination. The third one comes dedication. The fourth one is devotion. So only with these four D's, the three A's and three C's, the four D's will empower you, will create a history in your own identity, and it can be done. So thank you one and all for being with me. Thank you. Just hold. I'll let you know how to clap. There's a method to clap. Okay, we'll do it together. My students should know that, whoever attended. It is in this way. Make it fast, loud, put all your energy and strength. Yes, okay. So direct your own energy to yourself. Don't allow it to get wasted. It's your own energy. Okay, so thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for eruditing us on the topic of win yourself to win the world. I would now like to propose the vote of thanks for this session. On behalf of Bengaluru branch of SIRC of ICAI and SICASA Bangalore, I would like to thank Dr. Sarvamanagla Khanapuri for conducting such an enthralling session. I request Ms. Salome to present a memento to Sarvamanagla ma'am as a token of gratitude. Thank you, everyone. Over to MCs.